Hello everyone, this is Amritpal Singh. Welcome to my next video on Apache Hive. In this video, I'll be talking about one of the very important topic of Apache Hive, which is partitioning. So what is partitioning? Partitioning meaning is dividing the table in such a way that the related data will be stored together. Meaning is, let's suppose this think about a very big table, okay? I want to now divide the table, maybe let's suppose country wise, that all the data related to India will be stored at a one place, all the data related to the Spain will be stored in different place, and so on. This is the objective, that I want to organize my table in such a way that the related data will be stored in a single partition, different partition. So we have to divide my data. Like in a networking, we used to talk about or used to learn about fragmentation when we divide my data. But similarly, in this Hive, we have the same concept. Now we have a table instead of data packet. I'll be partitioning my table in such a way that the related data will be stored in a different partition. Okay, like one data of, let's suppose, of country India, it will be stored together. Of a Spain, it will be stored together. Maybe of China will be stored together in this way. Okay, for this little demonstration, guys, what I did, I have just created one data set. You can see this data set I'm using today. In this case, it's a three column data set. The first state, city, population. You can see that against Alabama, I'm having five entries because I'm having five cities which is present in the Alabama state. Similarly, three cities of Alaska and so on. What I'll be doing, I'll be dividing my data in such a way that I'll be ending up with the five partition. Why? Because I'll be dividing my data, my table, state wise. Because I'm having in total, there are five unique states. So this is my objective. This I'll be doing with the help of Hive partitioning. Okay, let's do it, guys, just to make you see that how thing works. First of all, I'll be creating its schema. You can see, guys, I've already logged into my Hive shell and I'm working under the default database. Let's do it. Create table. So I'm keeping it as states, state string, because my first column is state, second column is city, and third is population. I'm keeping population as bigint, guys. It is one of the primitive data type of Hive. Then row format delimited, and fields, you all have seen that fields are terminated by comma in my case. So schema is ready. Let's populate the table. Load data local in path, give the absolute path, because in my case it's not available in the same location. It's available on my local file system, and this is the file into table states. Done. Let's describe to check out whether everything is working fine. Okay, so it's recognized that state of type string, city of type string, population of type begin. Okay, the first step is done. It's been populated. Now, guys, it will be serving as my main table, my source table, from where I'll be getting my data. Let's create one another table which will be my child table. So this is my parent table, states. I'll be now creating my child table. Create table. I'm keeping this as a part name of this table. I'm keeping two columns, right? I'll let you know why. One is city, one is population. Because, guys, I want to divide my data state wise, right? As I've already have stated that I'm having five unique states, okay, in my data set, and I want to keep their data separately. It means I'll be ending up with the five partitions. So this data, let's suppose in a case of Alabama, I'm having five entries. So I'll be getting five rows under Alabama folder, three rows under Florida, and so on. It means that's the reason, guys, I'm now creating another table which will be my part table, because it will be storing my partitions. Okay, so create table part. I'm keeping city and a pop means population as a part of this table has its column names, and I'm using one important parameter or a keyword which is very important to understand. It is called partitioned by. It's the keyword that we use for partitioning in Hive. Partitioned by. As you all know that I want my table to be partitioned by state, so it will be state, and specify its type. That's it. It means my child table is ready, which is ready to accept the data from the parent table. Guys, we have to set one property if you want to do the partitioning. So this property is, have to write in this way, set hive dot exec dot dynamic dot partition dot mode equal to non-strict. Okay, done. Now last step is coming up, guys. We have to now populate my part table, okay, from the states table, because states table is my parent table, part is my child table. For this I'm using this insert overwrite table part partition. This is a keyword partition, and I have to specify my partition name. It is state. Now guys, I have, now whatever I've written here in the first line, it is my kind of a destination, means I've specified that where I have to write, where I have to overwrite. I've specified the table name part. So now here I have to specify the column names of my parent table, from where data will be coming. So in this case, order matters, because you know that in the part table I'm keeping CT at the first place, POP at second place. If I want to populate this data, I have to be writing this query in the same way. It means with the select query, these columns must be coming in the same order, city, pop, state. So please don't change the order from states, which is my parent table. Right now, guys, when I press enter here, you will see some kind of a MapReduce code going on in the back, behind the scenes. Why? Because guys, although we know that we are writing the queries in SQL, but behind the scenes, when you press enter, your SQL will be converted into MapReduce jobs, because Hive has came as an abstraction over the MapReduce. You can see something is going on, and we have seen some MapReduce terminology is coming here. Maybe some kind of a jobs, some kind of a like a map reduce something. It means some map reduce has been done. So let's check out whether I got my five partitions or not. You can see, guys, we can check out under this location. So I'm just opening up my new terminal, and we know that it's available under user hive warehouse, which is my default location of my warehouse directory. And it has to be open up with the Hadoop, because this user hive warehouse is a part of SDFS. User hive warehouse. And I want to check under part, because part will be available over there. Sorry, I've just written the wrong query. I just forget to write ls. I hope, guys, you can see that I got five answers here. Why five answers? Because I was having five total unique states, right? You can see this was my original data, and you can see that only five states were unique: Alabama, Alaska, California, Florida, Georgia. Okay, let me open up one. If I can open up for you. Okay. So if I'm going part, okay, let me ls state equal to Alabama. Okay, I got this file, right? Okay, let me open up with the cat command. Cat, and if I can open up, then I can make you see three zeros, so 1, 2, 3, 6 zeros. I hope you can see, guys, like I'm getting the only those states, okay, only those cities which are coming under Alabama. You can see Alabama, Athens, Auburn, Cullman, Enstone, Atmore, guys, and it's taking this comma as some special character. Okay, it hardly matters. So guys, this ends this video, and this proves that my data has been properly partitioned. I hope, guys, you must have understood this point, that what is partitioning. And guys, don't forget to give your valuable comment to this video. Thanks for watching. See you next video.